hey, I'm working from home too. Welcome to that home life. At any rate, welcome back, my fellow duplicants. Today, in Oxygen Not Included, we have to do a little bit of gas control. Because unfortunately, we've got natural gas and it's flowing all over the place, which could cause us some major issues if we don't take care of it. We got 29,000 calories left. I've been focusing down here on this cooling system quite a bit, and that has unfortunately caused me to not focus on food for a little while here. So some things got a little bit too hot here, like the Millwood. So I need to switch up my food strategy here, re-enable kind of all these critters here so that we can actually get some nice barbecue out of them. But I think we're going to expand the cactus up here. We have more than enough water to cover a lot of things that require water, which is these cactus right here. So we've got all this water from this cool steam vent. We've got two cool slush geysers. We've got another cool steam vent down here if we really want to get into it. Ooh, holy moly, that's 182 degrees Celsius. We got liquid phosphorus down there. I think I'll avoid drinking that. We've got all more geysers and stuff we haven't even uncovered yet. Look at that, one there, and a saltwater geyser right there. So I'm guessing water is no longer our biggest issue at all. We might as well use it. So, let's start off here by trying to expand our farm a little bit here. I think Meep will like that. A Squared asks, is there liquid phosphorus in Brathgar's energy juice? It's only used to get the power from, you know, from the juice to your lips. And then it condenses and goes back down and remixes it. You don't actually drink it. And at its core is some really hot salt. That's how it works. All right, first shape. What do we got here? Ooh, we've got ourselves an L. That'll work out. It's almost like I planned it that way. Okay, so I'm going to use that L just like so. Ooh, do I want to do that? Yeah, let's do that. That'll be great for our farm. Let's go for another piece here. Ooh, we got ourselves a J. If I put it here, that kind of limits my options. I think it'll be all right though. Let's go for it. One more piece. We might as well build up more pieces. We do need more stuff in general, so. Ooh, I think that is another J, if I'm correct. Uh-oh. So, if I put that right there, then yes, I could build up all of this. L, not J. Oh, that you're right, that is an L. If you flip it just right. So the L can go right there. All right, so that gives me some good spot here. This is warm enough up here to work with the cactus. So this right here is where I'm going to do a lot more of my farming stuff. So what I'm going to do is I'm actually going to build up a lot more hydroponic farm tiles here. So instead of doing all of these just like this, I'm going to swap those out for the hydroponics. Boom, just like so. And then we're also going to swap these out and maybe even those down there, or at least most of them. And then I'll probably layer this in a little bit more as we kind of get a little bit further into it. All right, so what do we have here? What do I need to get taken care of right away? Okay, I think the first and most important thing that I need to do right now to preserve what amount of food I have is to build up a storage box down here and then sweep the eggs into them. I've disabled the eggs, I think, from the dispensers up here, except that one snake kind of already found its way in. Because I think a lot of these, yes, they're all cramped. And they don't like being cramped. So that's actually slowing the amount of critters that makes it down here to the butcher station. So it's kind of a temporary fix, but at least that'll kind of bump our food up here in the short term, which is what I'm worried about. So if we take critter eggs real quick, and we say all of those, priority level 9, and we just say sweep only, and then we go down here, and we just sweep up everything in each area, then we should be able to take care of those. All right, dupes, why are you not harvesting this? Meep, what are you doing here? That's your job. Ah, you know what I should do? Here's what I should do. I have the food for, I have the water for it now. I should use the micro musher and crank up the lice to lice loaf. I was avoiding that for the longest time because I didn't, because water was the least of anything I had. Here we are, cycle 250, and we're doing lice loaf. Woo, big step up. All right, so here's my biggest risk. If I expand this farm, if it is not hot enough to run, then I'll have spent all of this effort and I won't get anything for it. Oh, those are all kind of high priority. Let's just set that to 8. We'll get it built. Come on, dupes. What are you doing, butcher station? Holy moly, why don't they ever stop running this thing? Stop. Mabe, you're sleeping on the job here. I need you to be harvesting, dude. That's your job. Get back to work. Mabe! Mabe, you're sleeping again. Clearly, we need two people doing farming, not just one. Alright, how are we doing oxygen-wise? Ooh, I think we're doing alright oxygen-wise. Food is clearly our biggest problem right now. Like, we're barely staying positive fast enough. But I think we're doing alright. We're keeping with it. This was a good move down here. We're making a little extra. We can always go to the mush bar if we really need to go to the mush bar. Although, I don't want to eat dirt if I don't have to. What I really want to do is get this farm up and running. We've got 44 spiky succulents now that we've been harvesting this for a long time, so. All right, here we go. I'm tired of these dupes not doing it. Priority level 9. See, there we go. Now I'm seeing some progress here. Who keeps dripping? Oh no. Oh no. Dupes. Who's entombed? Quark? How? What? You're not even visible, Quark. How did that happen? That's some next level entombing. Unreachable? Oh crap. How? Here, we'll attack this from many different angles here. Digging, priority level please. Try to get rid of the floor. We'll get you out of there, Quark. One way or another. Quark? Quark? Okay, you're back. Oh my gosh! No! Please! Drain the drain! I mean, I even put all of those little mesh tiles there. This pip's like, man, what's going on? There's oil everywhere. What a slick pip. Now you need to get some Dawn for that pip. I know, right? This is... We're gonna have, like, a major health concern. I'm gonna have to compensate the pip union or something. You're gonna be out for seeds. Dupes, you really are building this in the least productive way possible. You might assume that they would start at the nearest possible thing and then kind of work to the farthest possible thing. Not my dupes. Nope. If you really zoom in on this game, I swear, it's like, it's kind of like ASMR, isn't it? You just like hear all this little noise going on. When will Sweepy have his debut? That's a good question. It seems like one of the hardest maps for Sweepy to navigate. Alright, so we'll put a couple Sweepies in here. Here, let's put it right in here. Let's start off with this one. Let's take a look at the room overlay. So far, nope, still a stable. That's good. Hey, there he is. I think this Sweepy needs a name. What shall we name him? Something that goes well with snakes. Rattle Sweeper. Roller. Roller Sweepy. Oh man, this is what happens when you ask a bunch of technical people to come up with names. Sweepy underscore roller. With brackets. Swroller. There you go. Can you put a raw egg on Sweepy's head? Well, would that cause them to be cramped? Gosh, this thing's adorable, isn't it? I see what you're saying. Raw egg. Aha. Although I am curious if we can do this. Yeah, see? At least they aren't cramped. This poor Swroller here doesn't have any room to move. Poor guy. Still waiting for Sweepies to be able to use jetpacks. That would be amazing. Oh yeah, that's right. We had some Paku. Totally got distracted from that. Glad we haven't starved to death in the meantime. Alright, so let's deliver some water or something to this. Auto bottle. Priority level 9. We kind of bring in those fish. How much do we have down there? Oh, we got about 200 kilograms. There we go. We'll make it up to 400. Choose a blueprint, grab our Paku. There they go, and they'll flop on over to the right. There they go. Perfect. Mr. Turtle! No! You've died from old age. You know, we really don't have a good memorial spot for these dupes. I suppose this area will have to do. You're gonna need a big space for that. You're right, I am. Fabio's like so excited. Dude. You must not have liked Mr. Turtle at all. Why is this mealwood not being harvested? It's not that we don't have food, it's that you're not harvesting it. You've got one job, Meep. Where are my harvesters? No, that's where he is. Meep! You're just down here on the massage table watching the world burn, aren't you? He gains immortality and just like that, stops caring about everything. I think harvesting is about to become a very high priority for many people. Skyboy 96. Wait, Skyboy 96 is already here. Moreau. Welcome to the base. All right, so your priority is going to be farming. Hey, look at that, even like farming. Perfect. And your priority is going to be farming as well. There we go, now we got some food. Who's leaving these omelets laying around? Dupes, I'm working so hard for this food and you're treating it like it's dirt. Yeah, so right now I'm dealing with some pressure issues. We've got so much carbon dioxide. We don't have a lot of oxygen coming off of this just yet. Ever since we've been able to not deliver to this thing, it's really made for some weird things. It either like produces a ton of oxygen or it doesn't produce any oxygen at all. What I really need to do is close it down and then put a pump inside of there, or a series of pumps, so that I can control the pressure. And that way we can draw all of the polluted oxygen out of those bottles. How'd you end up with the ammo suit, Maru? I know, every new dupe that ever joins my base, they're all like, hey, check this ammo suit out. And then they just end up running around with it for like 5 cycles. There you go. No, that doesn't belong there. Seriously, you would have had to go through here, somehow navigate all the way over here, up and into the base. All right, so most of the construction there is done. Let's take a look at the oxygen. Oh yes, see? By re-enabling those, you suddenly flip the switch on whatever happens down here that lets so much water go, so much oxygen go. There's like some sort of thing when the water falls down and then the polluted oxygen lets loose a lot of stuff. Cool, thank you so much for using the Humble affiliate link. Thanks, guys. All right, so we've made some decent progress here on the farm, finally expanding that out here, so hopefully we can get ahead of food here again. But now, we need to actually pressurize this area up here, because the amount of oxygen that's up there is not a whole lot. First off, I'm gonna get rid of this little slickster that keeps consuming stuff. But then we're also gonna work on trying to get some more oxygen all the way up there, which, as you can imagine, is not super easy on my map, because there's not a great way for all that air to flow up there. We need more airflow tiles, we also need more pressure down below. Morty2K, welcome to the base. Yeah, I might have to throw a gas pump down. I have to put it like right here. The thing is, it needs to be, you can't use polluted oxygen, which is kind of one weird thing about this plant. It has to actually be the clean stuff. If it isn't that, then you'll just cause more issues. But hey, let's give it a try. Okay, we can see that these spiky succulents are indeed growing. That looks good. Ha, finally. Let's try to sweep this stuff up so we can actually see what we're doing. Alrighty, so in order to combat the sort of inconsistency of this algae terrarium system here, I've installed a mod that allows me to take these deodorizers and flip them upside down. Ah, just like that. Not only that, we've got a super air filter. Look at this monster. Yes. Now we're talking. Maybe my base won't be full of polluted oxygen after all. Getting rid of polluted oxygen is absolutely necessary if this farm is going to be successful at all. Because as you can see, having polluted oxygen up here means that it's not in the correct type of gas. Which, as you can imagine, is a bad thing. Means all of this work that I've done today might be for nothing if I can't get it to convert back into nice clean oxygen. So, I'm also going to go ahead and do this number. You can never have too many air filters, so here we go. More air filters. Oh yeah, look at that. That looks like some nice clean oxygen to me. Okay, this requires emptying. Let's go ahead and see if we can do that, huh? Have at it, dupes. Look at how much sand we're loading to this. This is just tons and tons of sand. What is its capacity? Who knows? I'm gonna go with a lot though. Boosh, look at it go. Those are awesome. Yes. Much better. I can work with this. Still, look at all of this polluted oxygen. Look how much there is. Uh-oh. Kind of got a food crisis at the moment. Come on, dupes. I need you guys to build this pipe. Come on. How is that unreachable? That is not unreachable. Are you kidding me? You can get right to that. Okay. There we go. All right. Let's see if I can get out of this problem. Jeez. Just looking for food constantly. All right. Here we go. Now we got things rocking and rolling. Put an air filter right there. A Mondo air filter. We'll get rid of this little guy. None of these puny filters. We don't need those anymore. Yeah, air filter. Alright, well that was a really successful cycle for making lots of oxygen. How much of it actually found its way up here? Not a ton, but it is at least... Let's take a look at our power here. I think I disconnected that. There we go. Now it's growing. Now we've got some oxygen. Oh yeah. Much, much better. Whew, I'm starting to get a little worried there. All right, so hopefully this gives us enough space to where I can actually go ahead and get my filter thing set up here and start getting rid of some of this natural gas and all of this carbon dioxide. We need to really store that stuff up because right now there's just too much of it. It's starting to build up. All right, so a few things that I'm setting up here is just a couple of wall gas pumps. And each one of these wall gas pumps is doing the exact same thing. They are looking for any gas that is the wrong type of stuff. So anything that is not oxygen is going to be kicked out of this base. And then it's going to run through a couple of filters, and if it's the wrong thing, you know, then it will be stored up in a tank. So I'm building one here, I'm building another one right there. These are kind of like the old school fart catchers. Because the problem is I got just a teeny tiny bit of carbon dioxide or maybe natural gas down here, and that's really stopping all of this from growing, which is really leading to why I'm having so many issues with food. Is I just get like the wrong type of gas just there for long enough, and that's really caused a lot of problems. Oh yeah, and these super air filters are doing the job so much better than the last ones. Look at that, just oxygen now. Good. So I'm going to do the same thing with this gas filter here, right? So if this is not looking for, I mean, that's kind of what it's doing, but it's not being very efficient about it. But essentially, that's essentially what that one's going to do if it's not oxygen. All right, so I'm just gonna get rid of a lot of these gas pipes. We don't need those anymore. And everything's just going to be, is going to flow into this gas pipe right here. So that's what's going to happen. You flow in. Same with this guy right here. Not like that. So I'm really just positioning these throughout my base anywhere that looks like it's going to be a problem spot. So, you know, we obviously have one down here, but I think we got one right up here as well. Just because I noticed that a little bit of carbon dioxide likes to settle into that spot. So we'll put in a filter and we'll just get rid of it that way. Boom. Simple. This is another spot where we're probably going to have a lot of natural gas. So this is a good way to kind of filter out that extra natural gas. Believe it or not, that comes off of this thing. How fast is natural gas? 90 grams a second, not too bad. So we'll set that up right there. That thing will probably run quite often. So, boom, just like so. Then we could take the NOT gate right next to that. Ah, there it is. That's what's up. The algae terrariums are under life support. Therefore, that was set to super high priority, so everybody was running to those constantly. That makes sense. I mean, it should be high, but not very high. Other people have other jobs to do. There you go. Fabio, don't do this to yourself. You did it to yourself, Fabio. These dupes. What will I ever do with them? Ah, yes, there we go. Look at all those cactus being harvested. Cacti or whatever. So much better. Crude oil, we should be able to go ahead and say not sweep only, but enable auto bottle. We can get rid of that stuff up here, bring it down over here. There we go. Ooh, except for that's already filled up. So I guess I gotta run that again. So hang on, I'm gonna go back to auto bottling. All right, so as we can see, this seems to be picking up oxygen. No, it should be not oxygen. See, now you're in oxygen. The point is all of this gas eventually, one day, will make its way back here and will eventually be filtered out in this stuff, if I can ever get somebody to build that. It's not like they don't have a few things to do. The thing is, these high-flow reservoirs take a really, really long time to construct. Alright, so now I'll run power to all of these, just like so. Boom. So the first one's looking for oxygen, the second one's polluted oxygen, third one is carbon dioxide, which is over here, then we have natural gas, last one is chlorine. There's some other gases that we might run into, but for right now, I think those are pretty much all the gases I'm dealing with. Unfortunately, the gas tank is so big, I actually cannot fit it in this spot here. So I think I'm gonna have to roll for another piece. Oh, a big old square. Ooh, I do like this square. That would actually be useful. I could put it right here. Yeah, so look at the gas overlay now. Mmm, all that oxygen and it's all nice and clean. So much better. We do have a carbon sink over here. This is interesting. Like, we might be able to use that for something productive at some point. It does seem like we have a couple of spots where I could be storing up food. I don't think bringing all my dupes over into one single spot where they're always going to be eating is a good idea. At least in this map, with the way it's set up, so I might have to do that. Look at how many critters I have down here. Look at how much food we have now. Look at this, 92,000. We have 35,000 calories of mush bar. We could probably stop making mush bar. Oh, I guess we've already stopped making mush bar. All right, let's filter some gas. I guess since I don't have anything else to do with this, we might as well do a high pressure gas vent right there. Just dump it out below the base. Unfortunately, I don't have the right background material for this shape. I don't have a lot of copper ore, and I have no way of getting more until I install a different mod. No. Why aren't you running? Where is my pipe broken? That is green. That is green, green. Ah, I found you. There we go. So here comes all of this gas, and now we shall see it filter. All right, let's take this oxygen, throw it back into the suits so that my dupes can actually use the suits. Okay, so that one should be running. This one down here is going to pick up all of the bad gas. We got some carbon dioxide. We also got a ton of natural gas down there. This should help clean this up. That'll be nice. All right, so I'm going to set all of these to be above 500. So as long as we got some pressure inside of here, we're going to run this. This pipe is connected to all of those filters we have down there, so it doesn't really matter what we have. The idea is that just as we go inside of here, it's always going to be lower pressure than everything else around it. So that way the natural gas doesn't flow out. At least that's the hope. So now we've got all of this gas fighting to find its way in. You know what might be a different idea for doing this exact same thing? What if we were to bring everything into a high flow tank? Therefore, it isn't interrupted at all. And then on the outlets, we run all of those through filters. So then this could pretty much be one continuous loop, exactly like we're doing over here with the liquid, so that it is continuously cooling, except for over here, we're not looking for temperature. What we're looking for is type. And the type gets filtered out as it continues to go around and around. Yes, I'm clearly not set up for that right now, but I think we can do it. I think I can get that hooked up. Let's go for it. So let's bring this over just like so. And then rather than using that vent down here to just kind of dump whatever gas we haven't figured out what to do with yet, we will bring it back up into this inlet. And that gas can flow out and run through the filters. There we go. This is looking good. All right, so now all of this gas is flowing into here and it's going to build up with a random assortment of gas. So let's get rid of this. We don't need that. So look at this. Hey, look at that. So the gas is flowing out and then oxygen's finding its way over here. Polluted oxygen's going over there. Carbon dioxide, if we have natural gas, that'll find its way in there. And then the last thing that we need to bring in here is chlorine. So I have one tank left over. So I'm going to flip this gas shut off from left to right. And we'll let it end up in there. So this last one is looking for chlorine. There you go. If we find chlorine, that will flow out over here and into this tank. Aha! Now, obviously, I do have some tanks that already have a fair amount in there, like natural gas. We'll have to use that and run that as a generator. Now, that's where things are really going to get interesting with automation, especially with kind of our advanced automation. So for example, if we have, I don't really know exactly how I'm going to do it, but I know that once this is above a certain level, we definitely want it to run. Davy boy, what in the world have you done? You walled yourself in here, man. Awesome. So this is pretty cool. Depending on what it is, it's flowing into our tank and then it's filtering out and going wherever it belongs. Nice. So how does our gas look now? Oh! Whoa, carbon dioxide, hello. I think we need to dig up some more algae, don't we? Well, we've managed to reduce the amount of natural gas in our base. However, we've now have a carbon dioxide explosion. That's not good. And we've got a little bit too much water down here. So let's mop that up real quick. Okay, look, the algae terrarium thing is interesting, but I'm tempted to, like, delete it forever. There we go. And just like that, loads of oxygen. This is the most inconsistent way to make oxygen anymore. Oh, it's crazy. Redstone, what in the world have you done now? Oh no. Serious, what a dupe. Come on. Oh geez, now everybody's catching fire. This is nice and cool up here, isn't it? Oh yes, beautiful. Yeah. Crispy dupes. I swear, every 5 cycles it feels like this game goes from, wow, we're doing great, to, oh no, we're just about to die. I don't have any point where I feel like I can actually end, so this is where I'm going to end right now. Thank you guys for watching. Hope you guys have enjoyed this little episode here of Oxygen Not Included. Thanks. Have a great day. Stay awesome. Peace. Mrothgar out.